Welcome back to the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm. The Southeastern Lion football team recently welcomed FBS opponent Texas State to Strawberry Stadium. Let's go out to Strawberry Stadium with Matt Sullivan and check out the highlights.
Brian Young scrambling hits Sam Fairley with a nice pass for a first down for the Lions on the opening drive of the ball game. Again, Sam Fairley, who's gained 94 yards on the ground with a big first down there with a run up the middle. Southeastern had nearly 500 yards of total offense. Brian Young, who threw for nearly 350 yards, finds Corey Theodore for one of his seven catches for 100 yards for the senior out of New Orleans. And Brian Young caps the drive with a nifty 17-yard run to give Southeastern an early 7-0 lead. Texas State would answer on its following drive, but not before Devin Walker stopping Terrence Franks in the backfield. Marcus Curry would cap the drive for the Bobcats with a 4-yard run, and the ball game was tied at 7. As Southeastern defending the Texas State option, Sam Fairley on the following drive, he'll score from 4 yards out, and the Lions regain the lead at 14-7. But Texas State comes back on the next play on the following drive. Sean Weatherford hits Darius Bolden on a 75-yard touchdown pass to cap a 2-play drive, and that tied the game at 14 apiece. Lions, though, with some key defenses. Tyler Stoddard, along with Caleb Muse, on a tackle on Franks. Franks had a big game for the Bobcats, but the Lions had some big performances themselves. A key third down pass to Sam Fairley kept the chains moving for Southeastern. And a pass to Simi Yarbrough, who passes Felton Huggins as the all-time leader in receiving yardage. Yarbrough with 2,417 yards now in his career as he passes Felton Huggins. Lions will keep the drive going. Screen pass out to Latron Weary. Weary with some nice blocks from downfield and gets a 27-yard gain down to around the 20-yard line. Lions would cap the drive. One play after Weary on a long run right there. Gets stopped at the 5-yard line, but gets the ball again on the following play. Scores from 4 yards out, and the Lions regain the lead at 21-14. Texas State trying to come back downfield, but a key stop there by David Durden. Durden with 10 tackles in the ball game, along with a sack and 2 tackles for loss. Yarbrough gets another pass from Young. Yarbrough finishing with 5 catches on the night to become the first Southeastern player and just the second Southland Conference player to get 200 catches in a career. Brandon Collins with a crossing route there from Young gets it down inside the 5. And the Lions would cap the drive as Weary would score his 2nd touchdown of the night. That gave the Lions a 28-21 lead. On the ensuing kickoff, David Durden forces a fumble. Michael Cheney is there to recover at the 20-yard line. As Southeastern forced 2 turnovers on the night, Seth Sebastian would cap the drive with a 45-yard field goal. And with just under 10 minutes to play in the 3rd quarter, Southeastern opened up a 10-point lead. Tim Hawkins of Texas State tries to get a key play there on 3rd down, but he's stopped by Avery Crooks. And then on 4th down, after a timeout, Texas State attempts a fake punt. Tay Alford is there to stop Ben Fallis just short of the 1st down, and the Lions, with excellent field position and a 10-point lead in the ball game. Texas State will get the ball again, but a key sack there by David Durden and Tremaine Lucas. 2 of the sacks on the night by the Southeastern defense. And Latron Weary would cap off the drive with his 3rd touchdown of the ball game, a 9-yard run And that gave Southeastern a 38-21 lead, and they would go on to win 38-28. As Brian Young in victory formation after a sack earlier by Frank Bryant, and Southeastern defeats Texas State for the third straight time in what is probably the final meeting between the two schools, as Texas State will now go to the Western Athletic Conference beginning in 2012.
Thanks, Matt. A huge win for the Southeastern Lion football team as they knock off Division I FBS opponent Texas State. Up next, the Lions will be on the road at Conway, Arkansas to take on Central Arkansas in a Southland Conference matchup. And then on November the 5th, they'll be back at home for homecoming here at Strawberry Stadium. For more information on homecoming events, check out lionsports.net.